For the past few weeks, I've been trying to discuss the ad'iya, the dua that we make in the salat, for the purpose of improving our salat and becoming from the people whom in their salat khashi'un. May Allah make us all among them. And we said many times that one of the ways to achieve khushu' is by changing the dua as long as it is authentic. So we studied four du'as before the Fatiha that are all authentic. Rasulullah ﷺ recited them one time or another. And we started last week, we studied four du'as, authentic du'as in the ruku'ah. We studied four authentic du'as in the ruku'ah. When we get up from the ruku'ah, there are two positions in the salat where we rush so much. The first is when we get up from the ruku' and boom, we dive into sujood right away. And the second is between the two sajdas. In order, insha'Allah ta'ala, to not fall into that mistake, listen to me attentively today, bi'ithnillah. We get up from the ruku', what do we say? Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. This one here, you have no option, no other option. The others, they have many options. But سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ, we do not hear any other narration that Rasulullah ﷺ said anything else. So we have to say سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ. But unfortunately, I can count in one hand how many people in this crowd know what does سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ mean, and we've been praying for 30, 40, 50 or 60 years. سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدًا إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. With the help of Allah, your salat will change starting from tonight. سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدًا. There are two words that we have to understand. سَمِعَ and حَمِدًا. In the middle, لِمَنْ, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ, easy. اللَّهُ لِمَنْ, we all know. But سَمِعَ and حَمِدًا, we have to know what they mean. سَمِعَ in general means heard, right? Here, it means something else. Allah said in the Quran, when Ibrahim said, الحمد لله الذي وهبني على الكبر إسماعيل وإسحاق إن ربي لسميع الدعاء لسميع الدعاء. الحمد لله that Allah have gifted me إسماعيل and إسحاق at an old age, and then he said إن ربي الله لسميع الدعاء. Here does not mean سميع mean that Allah heard my دعاء. No, Allah already إيش answered the دعاء. He already gave him إسماعيل and إسحاق. So the word سمع means سمع الله لمن حمد استجاب الله. Allah answered. Another دليل, that's from the Quran, from the Sunnah. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to seek refuge from four. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع وقلب لا يخشع ودعاء لا يسمع ونفس لا تشبع. Ya Allah, I seek refuge with you from a heart that is not humble, from knowledge that's not beneficial, and from a dua. Here, لا يسمع. Here, يسمع does not mean dua is not being heard. If you make dua, I'm standing next to you, I heard it. The sami' is not going to hear it. No, dua in لا يسمع means dua that is not answered. I seek refuge, Ya Allah, with you from a dua that's not being answered. So now here we know that سمع means استجابه, answer. سمع الله لمن حمد. What does حمد mean? الذي يصف الله بصفة الكمال حبا وتعظيما. One of the meanings of حمد here is the one who attributes to Allah the perfect attributes with love and veneration. Another meaning, the one who everything I have is from him. استجاب الله. The meaning of the سمع الله لمن حمد. Allah answers the one who believes that every blessing he has is from him. Allah answers the dua of the one who believes that every ni'mah he has is from Allah Azza wa Jal. What do we say right after that? ربنا لك الحمد. Allah will answer the one who says حمد. ربنا لك الحمد. I want to be from these people. So instantly I say ربنا لك الحمد. Now here, the first one I have no option. Here I have many options. Listen carefully. ربنا لك الحمد. ربنا ولك الحمد. Or you add Allahumma to each. Allahumma Rabbana laka alhamd. Allahumma Rabbana walaka alhamd. What do we do? Alternate. First rak'ah, Rabbana laka alhamd. Second rak'ah, Rabbana walaka alhamd. Wallahi ya akhwan, I'm talking from experience. The minute I start using my brain in the salat, the minute your salat will get improved. Otherwise, just mechanical movement without any thinking. The more you involve your brain, and especially as long as they are authentic, and alhamdulillah, they are all authentic. Listen to this one, beautiful, and that will help us stay a little bit longer and not fall into that mistake of rushing. Listen, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was praying, and he said, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ. He heard someone saying, رَبَّنَا لَكَ الْحَمْدِ حَمْدًا كَثِيرًا طَيِّبًا مُبَارَكًا فِيهِ. The salat finished. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned around. من القائل? Who said that statement? I can imagine that sahabi is probably, how could you add something? What? No, the sahabi said, أنا يا رسول الله. He said, رأيت بضعة وثلاثين ملكا. I saw over 30 angels racing to write it down. I saw over 30 angels racing to write it down. Hadith is in Bukhari. So, in order not to fall into that rush from now on, سمع الله لمن حمد ربنا لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. This حمد يا الله that I'm expressing is abundant. يا الله, this حمد is full of blessing. يا الله, this حمد is pure, طيب. يعني سبحان الله, I want myself and you to think, what am I being grateful for every single salat, 4 times or 2 times? والله, like the Shaykh just recited in Surah An-Nahl, إن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. الله, الحمد لله رب العالمين that you are a Muslim. الحمد لله that you are a مؤمن. الحمد لله that you have health. الحمد لله that you are from the people of the masajid. الحمد لله, نعم, لا تعد ولا تحصى. So I want myself to think about this when I say, ربنا لك الحمد. حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. The minute I say that, already I'm 10-15 seconds extra than my previous salat, because now I added something authentic and full of meaning. ربنا ولك الحمد. I can add to it in the beginning also. ولك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. Now listen to the last part. We always heard, and I always mentioned, that one of the etiquettes of dua is to do what first? Praise Allah. Praise Allah first, right? Praise Allah, praise Allah, praise Allah, and then ask. Just like the Fatiha. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, praise. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, praise. Maliki Yawm al-Din, praise. Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'een, praise. Now, time to ask. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. So the etiquette of dua is to praise, then ask. طيب, what did I just do? Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. ربنا لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى. سبحان ربي الأعلى. سبحان ربي الأعلى. الله أكبر. Start the دعاء. يلا. Start the دعاء. You already made all these praises. Now you're in the sujood, which is going to be our next week, inshallah ta'ala, if Allah kept us alive. We're going to talk about the importance of dua in sujood and what were the du'as that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made in sujood. You have already made the introduction. Allah said, I'm going to answer the one who has hamd. You said hamd and you went down and you start asking. And where did you ask? In the closest place to Allah Azza wa Jal. Wallahi, when we understand these things, all our salat was changed. Wallahi, I wish that there was someone who explained this to me 30 years ago. Wallahi, just pray, right? All you have to do is pray. And if you don't pray, you're going to hell. This is how we learn. If you don't pray, you're going to hell. Fix your salat, become khashi'. This is all not for you, for the sahaba. Subhanallah. So, ya akhwan, سمع الله لمن حمده. استجاب الله. Allah answers the one who believes that everything is from Allah, and he believes that all the perfect attributes belong to Allah Azza wa Jal.
إِنَّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَالْقَانِتِينَ وَالْقَانِتَاتِ وَالصَّادِقِينَ وَالصَّادِقَاتِ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَالصَّابِرَاتِ وَالْخَاشِعِينَ وَالْخَاشِعَاتِ والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيماً.